You're not fighting.
I gotta get out of the furnace.
Yeah, I gotta go.
What used to be really high? A lot of water.
My daughter.
You don't want to do that more than twice a day.
You need to stop playing. I'll walk.
This old thing's in tune first. That ought to do. Start out with our theme song along the river here. I hear banjos, we better paddle faster.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. That was a little song called Dueling Banjos, and it was featured in this rather unfortunate movie in the early 1970s called Deliverance. Well, even though the movie set us back about 30 years socially, it did have some pretty good music in it. I can remember hearing that song, Dueling Banjos, on the popular radio stations back when I was a young teenager. That's one of the songs that got me interested in learning how to play the banjo. Another reason I got interested in it was my own dear sweet grandmother. Grandmother loved all the old bluegrass gospel tunes of her era. She made sure every time I visited them, grandmother and grandfather lived down on a farm in Middle Georgia. We'd go down there and spend the weekend. She made sure I brought this old banjo with me. We'd sit on the front porch. I'd pick out a tune or two. She'd teach me the chords. I learned a few from her. But Sunday morning, no matter how late we stayed up Saturday night picking and grinning, Sunday morning she'd get us up early Sunday morning, feed us a big old country breakfast. We all get dressed in our Sunday best, and off to church we'd go with grandmother at her little country church down in Middle Georgia near a little place called High Falls, Georgia. Grandmother loved singing that church, so every Sunday morning, her and a handful of her friends would get up there in that choir loft, and they would sing at the top of their lungs, which could be a bit of a problem, because only about half of them could even carry a tune in a bucket. But there's one song they sang in that little country church that in my memory, that one song always sounded perfect, because I knew that was one of Grandmama's favorites of them all. A little song called I'll Fly Away. You know that one, sing along with me. Sunday morning, when the flight is over, Atlanta, Georgia. I was a kid, I didn't know any better. But in the fall of 2001, I had all I could handle of Atlanta traffic. So we moved up near Chattanooga, a nice little town called Cleveland, Tennessee. Once we settled in Cleveland, we found our church home at the Waterville Baptist Church. And there I got to meet Deacon Owenby. Now they warned me about this fellow thing. He's a really great guy. He just don't warm up to strangers right off the bat. And sure enough, Rick Owenby is a great guy. He's actually my mustache coach now. But the first time I met him, he was in line. He was kind of giving me the stink eye. He walked up to me and he shook his finger and said, "Fella, I heard something bad about you." I said, "What'd you hear bad?" He said, "I heard you moved here from Georgia. Is that true?" I said, "Well, yeah, but what's so bad about that?" He said, "Hold on, I'll get to that. But I heard something good about you too, fella. I gotta ask you, do you play the banjo?" I said, "Yes, sir, I do." He said, "Man, I love bluegrass music. Glad to have a banjo picker in church. But see, I bet you don't know our law here." I said, "What law?" He said, "See, there you go. You folks from Georgia move up here, you don't take time to study our laws. Here in the great state of Tennessee, it is state law that if you move into Tennessee, and if you play any of the bluegrass instruments, whether it be the banjo, the mandolin, the fiddle, the stand-up bass, or the guitar, then you got 30 days to learn a brand new song." What song you think Deacon Owenby was talking about?
Rocky Top.
Rocky Top, here we go! I was born and raised on Rocky Top, up in the Tennessee field. Telephone bills. Once I had a girl on Rocky Top, half fair, the other half cat. Not as mean, but sweet as soda pop. I still dream about that. Rocky Top, you'll always be. Home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top. Woo! Rocky Top team. And I must compliment the gentleman right here. Last weekend, we had a guy with a red ball cap with that white letter A on it, sitting all the way back down there. I want you to know he put his fingers in his ear. I had to go sit right next to him and play it all over again so he could hear it. Y'all enjoy your trip.
Ryan Longford, University of Tennessee, was around.
See, river's pretty.
It's a rare.
Thank you.
Yeah, Barney Fife might be the only one.
I guess y'all enjoyed the picking and grinning.
Oh, yes.
Probably won't let me sing with it. Of course, I don't know the one song. Wing, wing, well. It's been out a long time. Started out trading with an old gray mare, rode that thing from fair to fair, come a wing, 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 from the Jack Frost Fettle, Johnny Fair Fettle, come a long way from home. I tried to get Robert to pick his banjo the other day while I sung it. He told me just to sing off the bell. And I told him I didn't know that song. It must be a pretty hard song to learn, but I ain't gonna hurt anybody. Hope y'all enjoy the rest of the trip.
Thank you.